गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, आई रेशमा जैन एज असिस्टेंट ऑफिसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू लर्न यू अ टॉपिक ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयर आर्किटेक्चर यूनिट 2, दैट इज फ्रेमवर्क मॉडल. नाउ इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी लर्न about architecture model. In that topic we discussed all about architecture, software architecture, right? Now in this lecture we discuss about framework model. As the name implies, framework, basically framework is a standard way to build and deploy applications. It is reusable design platform. An architecture framework is an encapsulation of a minimum set of practices and requirements for artifacts that describe a system architecture. Software architecture process framework is a foundation of complete software engineering process. Software process framework include all set of umbrella activities. It is also include number of framework activities that are applicable to all software project. The process of framework define a small set of activities that are applicable to all types of project. It provide a standard rule. Basically, the software process framework is a collection of task set. Task set kya hote hai? Task set consists of a collection of a small work, task, project milestones, work productivity and software quality assurance point. So an architecture framework provide principles and practices for creating and using the architecture description of a system. It structure the architect thinking by dividing the architecture descriptions into domains, comma layers or views, and offers the model typically matrices and diagram for documenting each view. So this is the software framework diagram. First we see the process framework, then we see the framework activities jiske andar aap dekh rahe hain task sets hain. Task set ke andar different task hain, milestone work product hain aur SQA points hain. This is the software process framework. A generic process framework encompasses the 5 activities which are given below one by one. So first we have to communicate with our customer for the requirements. Then first we need what has to be done. So then we have to plan that requirements. Step by step planning should be there. Then plan, if once we have planned our targets, then we model that things, then we construct that thing and finally deploy that things, right? So communication in this activity, heavy communication with the customer and other stakeholders' requirement, gathering is done. Project requirements are collected in this activity. This framework activities is the main focus of the project managers and stakeholders. This framework activity include communications and coordination with the clients. Now next is the planning. In this activity, we discussed the technical related task, work schedule, risk, required resources, etc. This framework action incorporates data about the technical work to be planned, risks to be faced, resources needed for task completion, the decision of the milestone deadline to release the product in the productions. So now next, the construction in software engineering construction is the application of a set of procedures that are needed to assemble the product. In this activity, we generate the code and test the product in the order to make better product. Now last is the deployment. In this activity, a complete or non-complete product or softwares are represented to the customer to evaluate it and give feedback. On the basis of their feedback, we modify the product or supply better product. So umbrella activities include risk management, software quality assurance, software configurations, software management, that is SCM, measurement of formal technical reviews. So these are the activity involved in umbrella. Software project tracking and control, what happens in this activity? The developing the team assess project plans and compare it with the predefined schedules. If these project plans do not match with the predefined schedule, then the required actions are to be taken. Next is the risk management. Risk is an event that may or may not occur. If the event occurs, then it causes some unwanted outcomes. Hence, the proper risk management is required. Next is the software quality assurance. In this SQA is the planned and systematic pattern of activities which are required to give guarantee of software quality. During the software development meetings are conducted at every stage of development to find out the defect and suggest the improvement to the product code quality software. FTR meeting conducted by the technical staff. The motivation of the meeting is to detect quality problems and suggestion improvement. The technical person focus on the quality of the software from the customer point of view. Measurement consists of the effort required to measure the software. The software cannot be measured directly. It is measured by the direct or indirect measures. Software configuration management. Basically, it manages the effect of the changes throughout the software process. Reusability management. It defines the criteria for reuse the product. The quality of the software is good when the components of the software are developed for certain applications and are useful for developing other applications. Last, work product preparations and productions. It consists of the activities that are needed to create the documents, forms, lists, logs, and user manuals for developing the software. So this is all about the framework model. Thank you all.